Today on the Boot Guy, we're talking about the Red Wing 4216, the BOA lacing system. Now, first off, I want to dedicate this video to a guy who's been emailing me, Andy. Andy asked me about the BOA system, what I thought about it, and I figured I might as well do a video about it and let you guys know whether or not this is worth your time, your money, any of that stuff. So, the 4216 is waterproof. The 4216 is a direct attached sole and a comp toe. It's lightweight, it's comfortable, and it's made pretty nice. One of the finer points about this boot is there's not a lot of pieces of leather. So there's not a lot of little chunks to come undone to crack and break. It's one continuous piece from the heel cup all the way around the front. So that's one continuous piece of leather that's wrapped around inside the sole for their direct attach system. It is an EH boot, so that means it's comp toe, it's got a composite shank, and there's no metal on it that's going to be conductive. That means you electricians out there, you guys would probably really love this boot if you had to wear a safety shoe at work or on certain job sites. Red Wing waterproofs the leather, and they add a waterproof barrier built into this boot, so that means you're going to get a lot of flexes out of it before it starts to leak. And it will start to leak. All boots like this will eventually leak, especially direct attach boots, because you just keep flexing that booty, that baggy, whatever you want to call the systems inside the boot. All right, so now we're going to get to the BOA system and what I think about this. So if you haven't seen the BOA system, there it is. It's a push and pull button lacing system. You pull it out to unlace the boot, and you push it in to tighten the boot down. Is that not only does it tighten the top part, but if you've got a wider foot or if you've got a big instep on your foot, it's going to tighten and loosen around those sections. Just like shoelaces, sure, but they're not shoelaces. So if you've never seen the BOA system before, you got to understand that this has come from the fishing world where you have to wear waders boots, the snowboarding world where you're in and out of your boots really quickly to get on and off your snowboard. And the first place I saw them was in motorcycle shoes. I saw them in high-end motorcycle boots. I saw the BOA system before I saw it on work boots. Now, a question I get asked a lot, what happens when it breaks? Well, you replace it. They sell the kits and everything. I mean, it isn't like this is such an odd thing. You can go to any sports store today and pick up a BOA replacement system. They're not expensive. I think they're anywhere between $12 and $29 to replace the whole mechanism. Guys sometimes say to me, well, it seems like it's a pain in the ass if you should break that. Well, all I can say is in the 4 years that I've been selling BOAs, that I've had to replace laces with customers just out of my own curiosity, asking them to come back if anything should happen so that we can look at it together and I can learn how to replace them. Twice out of 100 and some odd pairs, two. Now that's one individual statistic. Think of all the shoes that Red Wing has sold with the BOA system. So I think it's pretty dependable. The fit on this boot is really nice. It's a generous fit. You get this nice oblique toe. You get all this space inside here. I haven't had any real problems fitting this boot, but most of the guys who do buy it usually have pretty wide feet, so they're taking the double E's. So the inside, well, check that out. Red Wing's own killer urethane insole. That's a nice insole. And it's returned, it's shaped nicely. Since it's a waterproof barrier, they got all the right perforations in there so you can have air that moves around the bottom of your foot so bacteria doesn't collect in the bottom so your boot starts to stink after a few weeks. It's pretty nice. If this boot has the characteristics that are going to make your job easier and better, I strongly suggest that you take a look at the BOA. Not because of the lacing system, but because of the fit of the boot. You might be won over by the lacing system because you've got something that you don't have to tie, you just click and twist. And for a lot of guys, that's pretty important. So that's the Red Wing 4216 BOA. If you've ever worn the BOA or anything with a BOA lacing system, please comment below. Let guys know the longevity of your wires and of your cranks and all that stuff, if they've worn out, if they broke, if you hated them, if you loved them, please let me know. Comment below. So if you should have any questions about this Red Wing or any Red Wing that I have reviewed, please send me an email. If you're about to pick up a new pair of boots and you're kind of on the fence about this one or that one, hey, send me an email, pick my brain, see what I got to say about it. And if you should have any requests for boots that you would like to see me review, I've got a million ways for you guys to get in touch with me. Twitter, Instagram. So until the next time, I'm the Boot Guy. Thanks a lot for watching.